Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. In this video I'll show you how can you make your own boost converter, which will allow you to power high power LED or by such an extent charging up a drill battery. Usually in this day you can find already such device on the internet for very little price, but nothing can compare with something you do with your own hands. And for that, in this video I'll show you how can you make your own version of a boost converter. The boost converter which you will make will be based on UC3843, which is a current mode PWM controller, which is the same IC found on the two boost converter which I was used in my DIY studio like. Link can be found in the description. Now the schematic is in front of you. The circuit is very simple and very reliable and can deliver up to 150 watts and with some extents even more with some modification. Let's consider the principle of the circuit operation. This is a simple voltage regulator with short circuit protection, so called booster. The simplified topology of operation is the same as flyback converter, the inductor choke with minimum of 2 winding and a galvanic isolation between them. The main IC is from the family UC38, in this case is the UC3843. In general, the input or the output is quite wide. By rotating the trimmer will be easy to get other voltage at output, so like that the circuit can be used to charge anything. The pin 6 will be responsible to provide the signal to our gate of our transistor. When the transistor is open, the inductor starts building up the magnetic field. And after, when the transistor is closed, the inductor will pump out the energy stored into the capacitor bank we have at the output. The phenomenon is called self-induction and it is a characteristic which mostly all the inductors have it. The voltage of self-induction can be slightly higher, even 10 or 20 times, depending on the type of the inductor being used. After, a half-wave rectifier made of two discrete diodes can be added before the output. For burst of self-induction, for straightening up the current being stored in the capacitor at the output. The shunt, which is a 1 ohm resistor, is being used for providing feedback to the pin 2 of our UC3843. I choose a SMD version of it due to the lack of the space, but you can choose any with at least 2 watts capability. Now let's start with the building process by grabbing all the required components and start to soldering them to a prototyping board, often called Vero board. First step will be to add our IC socket in the place and solder it. After, we will need to do the same process with all the remaining components for our circuit. Let's add the inductor choke, which in my case it's a 100 mH toroidal inductor with a diameter of wire around 0.4 mm. The next step will be to add our transistor, in this case I will using one of my favorites, the RFZ44N. And also don't forget to add a small heatsink to the transistor to keep it cool. And after all the required components has been soldered, we can power the board using a power supply, or in my case using my battery pack which I was having made a while ago. Now by turning the potentiometer we can increase the output voltage up to 40-43. Keep in mind, when we have a touch a load, the total output power can be slightly decreased. The circuit is working very well, I may say, so I have made two of them. And also, I am planning to come in the nearly future with a more powerful version of it. So that is all for today. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!